So, we have another race today in the D class. And I headed on down to the local used car lot that specialized in European cars. And I perused the available vehicles. And I found that they had an old used Renault, a Gordini. So I picked up one of these Renaults. I've actually never used one of these in a race. I did get the car and drive it around offline to gain enough points to do some upgrades to get it into the D class. And here we have the first qualifying lap where I discover there's some interesting attributes about this particular vehicle that makes a fellow on occasion say, whoa. It's somewhat, in my opinion, a somewhat unstable platform. But it does manage to get it on the track fairly fast, even with the aerodynamic characteristics of a barn door. Now this course is the first qualifying lap, so I'm not really sure what my times are going to be like yet. I did not upgrade the stock brakes on this car, but the stock brakes that are on it are awfully effective, in certain instances overly so. Whoa, whoa, Nelly! Okay, let's get this beast under control here. Watch out for that wall. Well, that wasn't a very inspiring first lap, although I did manage to get second as far as the qualifying goes. And wouldn't it be nice if I was able to keep that position? But as I make my way around this third and final qualifying lap, I'm surpassed by other drivers that I don't see. And I drop down to fourth. Somebody else just starting their qualifying. Oh, there's that wall again. Oh, darn. Would have been nice if I could have avoided that. but that lapse in time cost me a bit. Because I end up in sixth for qualifying. And now I have the boys in the pits check it over so that I can get ready for the main event here. And we've got, looks like Lightning McQueen is on pole position. Several Mazda Miatas are holding position up front in first, second, and third. A little Lotus, a Mercedes, oh, a VW, Mitsubishi, an Acura Integra, and of course, the Renault, the shoebox, the greenhouse, oh, a Ferrari. We got Magnum PIs is racing today. Oh, wait a minute, that's the wrong color for Magnum. So now everything is loading. Huge files that these games have. So as the race begins, things are looking somewhat promising. I'm able to beat these guys around this first turn, heading into the second turn, and carrying up speed and heavy braking with a really sharp left-hander here, and then another slow right. That Lotus decided to introduce himself. Trying to avoid that Mazda right there, and I ended up sliding off track a little bit there. Sure if that off-track violation was for me or for this Mazda right here. And we've got a Datsun in front of us. Most people would think that's a 240Z. But that's actually the Japanese version of it. So it's a fair lady to see. The guy, of course, has got the wide body kit on it. Reminds me of that race car that Paul Newman used to drive. I'm doing my best to try to rein these guys in that are in front of me. and at the same time try to become familiar with the various attributes of this Renault, which is something that I'm not very familiar with. And see, there's another, I'm not sure about that. It said an off-track violation, but I was right in the middle of the track, so I don't know. Maybe that was somebody else. Started the race. Got a couple of laps left. The real question is, can I maintain it? Bumper cars, and that allowed that fair lady to get past me, come around the outside. There's I think that might be a Clio or no Clio, but I certainly miscalculated that downshift there. That's one of those little Fiat 500s. He seems to be pretty quick. Because all the progress that I had, well, I've lost that. And this fair lady, he slid pretty heavy on that last corner. That allows me to get up enough speed to hopefully catch the inside corner on this one, but not quite able to make it. But I think I got more speed down the straightaway than he does, so this back long straightaway at Homestead, he's still pulling away. I definitely went off track there, bouncing around like I'm on a fucking Bronco. Slides a little bit right there, and that gives me an opportunity to catch up to him better. And he misjudges this corner a little bit and allows me around the outside. And now it's a drag race down this short chute straightaway to see who can get to that next corner first. I did make contact with you there. Now, I brake pretty heavy on this one right here to allow this guy to go around me, which he does. And so does a Buick Regal, the Skull Bandit. So I ended up in ninth place. Not too bad for the first time racing with this particular car. And that's my race for today. Hope you guys liked it. See you on the racetrack.